soon as I step in the club, I swear, my, you can feel the attention shift. Start around 12, ended up around 2, I better leave them off than I came here with. I can't be responsible for what I say or I do when I talk intoxicated. Shorty say I told her I love her, I put out the next morning, said time must have been faded. I don't know what you heard about me, but the word about me is I'm no trick, I'm no sucker, I'm no chump. I be in the VIP with my around me, saying y'all can have whatever you want. Me, I get it in Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Yeah, what man quiet when you walked in the building?
Yeah, man, I'm excited.
You scare people here or something?
Crowd goes wild.
Congratulations on a great video game. It's been out for a while.
Yeah.
So the big question to everyone is, will there be a sequel?
Well, I'm hoping that we'll be able to do it. With the success of this actual project, I look forward to trying to do it again.
Have the fans reacted to the video game?
Well, they said what you said. So it's a good video game. They enjoyed it. So, I mean, for me, I had opportunity to play with some people online. And that was exciting, and another way to reach people that are aware of me.
Now we have to ask, are you any good at the game?
Pretty good. I like to think I'm the best, you know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right, of course.
I'm going to say pretty good, just in case somebody come in here that really know how to do it.
And what's the feeling like? It's a very, you know, it's a feeling very unique that only you have and a few other people in the world are being able to play as yourself in a video game. What's that feeling like when you first do it?
That's exciting. You know, like Tony and Banks and Who Kid would rather play themselves than to play me, but
right.
You know, that's cool. I mean, I like to be a part of designing and marketing a video game that I'm not actually in. So I talk to TGQ and different.
All right, so that's for the future. All right, let's run through a couple of things very quickly. You're in New York shooting a movie at the moment.
Yes, I'm currently shooting with movie 12, Joel
right.
Schumacher.
What's your role in that film?
I play Lionel in that film.
Okay, and who is he?
Well, I mean, he's... you're going to turn us into an actor's the studio.
Yeah, go ahead. Inside the actor's studio.
Inside the actor's studio. But, I mean, it's an interesting character. The dynamics of it is it's kind of extreme. You know, I play a drug dealer that doesn't actually need support. He's previously been an enforcer, so he doesn't really have people around him. And I'm the connection between... I'm from Harlem.
Right.
And there's a connection between me and... kids in Midtown,
mm-hmm.
What wealthy kids in Midtown, and I feel like it's exciting to be in the around the danger that's in the inner cities on some level, so they make their way down.
We see you yesterday all over the press with Chase Crawford. Were you aware of him as an actor? Were you a fan of Gossip Girl and stuff like that?
I got a chance to see it.
All right.
You know, so I mean, it's cool to just be in the presence of talented artists.
Another computer game that was being turned into a movie you spoke about before was Saints Row. What's the situation with that?
Well, I was, you know, we was trying to option the rights,
yeah.
So you know, we're still working on that. And the more we talk about it, the more expensive it may get.
There you go. Another quick movie question. The Expendables was a film that Sylvester Stallone very much wanted you to be part of. Great cast. Arnold Schwarzenegger down, Mickey Rourke, Jason Statham. You're not doing it, though.
Yeah, I couldn't. Dolph Lundgren is also in
right.
it. I think Arnold Schwarzenegger...
Sylvester Stallone, Mickey Rourke, Jason Statham, basically every major.
Yeah, Jet Li also.
Jet Li as well.
Yeah, he's in there.
You couldn't have done
that. I couldn't. The time, the commitment was a little bit much for me right now, considering I'm finishing up my album. I had to go mix records. I just got back from Detroit prior to me starting 12. Me, M, and Dre finishing up the actual album. And it's clear for me now creatively because we got M completed. So his album is mastered, mixed and mastered, and ready to be presented to the public.
It's always something that you went and said was that you'd wait for him to put out those two songs before you started focusing on yours. Now that that's done, before I self-destruct was, you know, you completed it a while back. How different is the album now to what it was before, and in what way?
It's about 30% of what I had when I felt like I was finished.
So what's the biggest change in it?
Well, the production, a lot of it, Dre made a lot more of the music, this one, the actual album now. And I rewrote some concepts, because to me sometimes it would sound like I'm absolutely out of my mind if I played you the music, but it gets dated because I've been playing it
right
to myself for so long that I'm no longer as excited as I was when I wrote it for the first time. So I'm making new material and adding to that.
You always like to write about stuff that's current and up to date.
Absolutely.
What are you writing about right now?
Well, I've been conceptually doing some different things that directly apply to what I... the initial concept of Before Self-Destruct. And I wrote, produced, and directed my first screenplay.
Congrats.
Yeah, and it'll actually be in the album packaging, so you get the DVD and you get the actual the album. And I just wanted to make sure my fans had the opportunity to see my first effort. And it allowed me to create cause and effect. A lot of times when a song is only 2 minutes and 50 seconds or 3 minutes, you can only make descriptions of action. You can't create reason for why a person would do something like that or how it could happen.
All right, and very quickly, because I guess we're getting wrapped up. You brought up the Eminem record. People have had a taste of it now. 3 yeah. came out. We had two songs before, even a video for We Made You. What is the rest of the record all about? No doubt you've heard it.
It's great, man. I think you should expect it to go up. Like, I felt like those choices were, you know, impersonally, I think that this single, the first single, was one of his better records lyrically.
Right.
And he put it out, and, you know, obviously he felt the same way, but he got some records on this actual album that are way better to me, because it was so much material that he split it into two albums. So they get Rehab, and then probably in the fourth quarter you'll hear him with the next album.
So many people consider Eminem your mentor. You're the one that's been, you know, in the last couple of years, there on the street level, living
right.
the industry. So does that, you know, he's been, it's fair to say, kind of reclusive in a while. Has that dynamic shifted? Are you the one to advise Eminem?
Absolutely not. Em is like, when they see me as my mentors, the people who've been paying attention. You know, the people who just decided to tune in after he went, you know, on hiatus, they would just see 50 Cent. You know what I mean? But a lot of times, the creative decisions, before I present it to the public, I use him as a soundboard. I say, what do you think? Are you sure this is right?
Because okay.
I don't really have too many people that I trust as much as I trust him, because he's like, he's already accomplished so much as an actual artist that there's no, how can I explain it? There's nothing that he's actually after from the material. He's just being an artist.
He's content.
Right. So for me, it's not like there will be any type of reasoning why a person would say, nah, don't do that. Maybe because they had an idea of a song that they could write, the similar, or, you know. So he just gives me an honest answer every time, so I use it.
All right, very quickly, watch Keisha throw a punch in my direction. Rick Ross's album debuted at number one on the Billboard charts.
Yeah.
Did you hear it? What were your thoughts, and what do you think about
being
number one?
I didn't get the opportunity to hear his record, you know. But a lot of freak numbers come out of Def Jam system, you see that?
The sales were around 150 plus
yeah,
something.
Yeah, I mean, just look at it.
Is there such a thing as a number one flop? Like the concept of a number one flop. Maybe number one on the Billboard's about 156,000. May not be as much as I guess people were hoping for that record.
Well, I think it could be a disappointment to the system based on how much of an effort and money that they spent marketing. But you can't call a number one a flop under any circumstances. So still number one.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Me, I'm the life of the party. A little bit of juice, little bit of